Hi all, welcome back to the Danalyser. In today's video, we are going to calculate weekly growth rate in Data Studio. Before we move on, I would like to take some time here to walk you through how this works. So first of all, to enable us to calculate the percentage growth, we will need to prepare a table that looks like this, that I highlighted here. So we will have a year week, a total order, and the total order in the last week so that we can calculate the percentage based on this on a row basis. And if we look at our raw data, we actually have date and order. So first step we need to do is to aggregate them into week level. So here is what it will look like. And then further on, we will need to join back the data set because remember, we want to have a last week order side by side with current week order. So how we join them is that we'll have to join via the common key. So now we have two exactly the same data set. So how do we join it so that we will get the last week order side by side with the data set one? So first of all, we will need to add a week to the current data set. So imagine for this column, we're going to add 1 to the week number. And this will remain the same. The total order will remain the same. And this would be our last week order. So here, when we are doing the joining, you will see something like this. So week 2 will join with week 2 over here. So you'll get 50 here. And week 3 will join with the next week, if we have week 3 over here. So basically, this is what we want. And after that, we will only remain one same column, meaning for this column and this column is actually the same because we are using the same key to join. So in the end, we'll get back this table after the self-joining. And after that, we are going to add a calculated formula here to help us calculate the percentage change from last week. So that's the overall pipeline of how this works. And now I'm going to implement this concept to our dashboard. So first of all, remember our first step is to create a week level aggregated data set. So that can be done using blended data. So to create a blended data source, you can go to resource and click manage blends. Here you can click add a blend. And right after that, we are going to select the data set that we are going to use as the source and drag and drop the columns that we need into the dimensions and metrics. And here, instead of the original date, I'm going to add a new column for the year week. So here I'm using a formula called year week for that purpose. And for the new field, I'm going to just name it as year week and click apply. And now we are done with the first step. Let me just save this and show you how it looks like. So click add a chart and click a table. And here, just going to switch this to dimension and total order to metrics. And let's try to sort them based on the total order. Okay. So it seems like the numbers here is tally with the table on the left. So I'm going to just proceed with this. So the next step is actually to do the self-joining. Here things get a bit more advanced. So basically you can just click add another table and select the exactly same data set. Here for the total order, I'm going to just remove it and add a new column here for the date column, which is this one. We're going to add 1 to the existing week number. So first of all, I'm going to use date time add because we're going to add a week to the date. Here for my own practice, I always use days. So here I'm adding a 7 days, sorry, no S, to the date. And then right after that, I'm going to convert this to year week format. So here, same, I'm going to just name it as year week. And we were going to add total order to the metrics as well. And for the join configuration, I'm going to choose left outer for the join operator. For the join conditions, we are going to use the year week as the join condition. So for the total order, just cross it off. And after that, click save. So now in the data, new data source, we will have 1 dimension for year week and 2 total order. So this one is actually the current week total order, and the second one is actually last week total order. So let's rename this, because if the column name is the same, we can't differentiate which one is which. So here we have just renamed this. Now you can see that the column name is being updated. And now we can click save and close this window. Now we can add the newly created fields into here and check if it's correct. So now instead of sorting by total order, I'm going to sort by year week in ascending order. So you can see that for week 23, for last week total order is taking back the year 22's one. And others are actually all correct. So now we are ready to create the new dimension, sorry, the new metric to calculate the percentage change. So here, under the metric, click add metric. And here, click create field. So here, I'm going to calculate using total order minus last week order and divided by last week order. So here we're going to say percentage change. For the type, we're going to change it from numeric to percent and click apply. So now we have the percentage change added. So far this has been working, but if let's say you want to use the time series chart, this doesn't work. So for example, when I'm trying to add a time series chart, this doesn't work for us. And what if we are trying to add a bar chart? So for bar chart, you can do this, and for the dimension, you can also sort it by year week so that you get a time series trend. So from here, let's see if we can use the line and combo chart. So for the metric, we are going to use total order and the percentage change. So I'm going to go back to this table chart and grab the formula. And let's go back to this bar chart again and add this formula here. Going to call it percentage change. And for the style, so for series 1 is actually referring to the total order. So I'm going to make it a bar chart and using the left axis. For number 2, which is the percentage change, I'm going to change it to line. And I'm going to change the axis to right hand side. And let's show the axis title as well, because this can easily get confused. Okay. Alright. So now I'm just changing the sorting to ascending. And yep, this is what you can do in Data Studio if you utilize the data blend function. So far, this is what I have found in Data Studio that has been working for me. If you have any other solutions, feel free to share them with us in the comments below. And I'll see you next time. Bye bye.